Hi, thank you for coming. Diane Potter Yoga. Today we're going to do a long, my goal is to have a very long flow with no repetition after the initial warm up and surrender, ground. You know, I like to have equal parts on both sides through that, and then the maybe a more challenging sequence of balance poses, transitions, and I think it'll be fun. I'm hoping you're fun. So let me start right away with child's pose. So knees about the width of the mat, sit between your knees and just child's pose, heels to your feet. You can rock back and forth, side to side a little. Put your head on the floor, maybe even rock your head. Take some deep, soothing breaths for your nervous system. And walk your hands a little longer. Let's seat your hips a little bit back. Start to tent out your hands. And press your right armpit into the ground. Press the side of your right hand into the ground. Maybe rest your head on your arm as you imagine planting your armpit on the ground. And let's flip the other left hand. The side of the hand is down. You reach, maybe your head rests on your arm as you reach your left armpit to the floor, stretching through the side body. And then tense your fingers out, put your chin on the ground, and tuck your head. Reach your arms back to your side. You can press your hands right under your ankles. Just a few breaths here. Put your hands forward again. Let's roll up, chin to your chest. Hips are rolling forward. So reaching forward. As you're rolling through each vertebra of your spine, you're heading towards a cobra. Put your shoulders back and bend your arms and lift your heart. Lift your chin. And then bend into your knees and lift your tailbone and keep your chin lifted all the way to your heels. Your butt goes to your heels. Once you hit your heels, you tuck your chin and you round through your spine. You could even come up onto your fingertips. And pushing your hips forward as you're making space for your spine. Back into a cobra pose. And then reach back. And let's take some of these hands facing the outsides of your mat, like just rocking side to side on your wrists, warming up your wrists. You make some circles around your wrists. Down, this is called Dancing Lion. And the other way. And then come to a downward facing dog, pedal first. Maybe walk your hands, feet halfway to your hands. You can make a really nice half down dog. Maybe like a tight little down dog here. Press your chest to your legs. Maybe take your right hand to the outside of the left arm, left leg, left ankle. Switch hands. Lift under your right armpit. Pull your body close to your legs. And then let's walk a little bit closer to your hands. If you're bending your legs, it's fine. First one is perfectly fine to keep your legs bent. Just your chest, your belly is resting on your legs. And you're working towards straight legs. That may not happen. Relax. You're still a really good person. Just breathe into whatever is happening. Make sure you're relaxing the neck, relaxing the shoulders. You can sway side to side. Back and forth. So what happens when you push your weight into the tops of your feet. If you are bending your legs, see what happens if you shift your weight into your heels. If your legs are straight, shift your weight into your toes. Core engages so you don't fall over. Keep raising your tailbone to the ceiling. Breathe. Surrender. Hands touch the floor. You can walk back to a plank pose. Hold a plank. Just make some circles on the arms again. Core is engaged. And the other way. Drop your knees to a hover. Continue, sway back and forth, or up and side to side. Circling on your wrists, using your core. And drop your hips and feet, drop your knees down. Stretch your right leg out and your right arm straight out, reaching away from each other. Elbow to your knee, forehead to your knee. Pull everything in, exhale, inhale, lift up. Inhale, lengthen, exhale, fold. Inhale, reach. Exhale, fold. Inhale, reach. Exhale, fold. One more. Inhale, reach. Let's reach around. Hold into the right foot. Stretch through your shoulders. Take the right leg straight through your hands. Come into a lunge. First lunge of the day. You can sway this way. Sway side to side. Release your neck, sway your neck, sway your hips. Sway your knees. And straighten. Let's just back it back and forth. Inhale, look up, chin up. Exhale, fold over the leg. Inhale, look. Forward, reach forward. Exhale, fold over. One more, reaching forward. Bend the right, left leg. You stay here, or you can come down to your elbow. Hold on to your right ankle if you'd like. If you'd like to hold on to your left foot as well, and pull it towards your hip if you'd like. Breathe. Breathe. Back. Come back to frame the foot. Jumps up. Put your right hand back along the back of your leg. Reverse. Reverse warrior. Grounded. What do you call this? Maybe half or on your knees. Switch arms. Fold over the leg.
Release your head. Toes to the ceiling. Hip. Whatever feels natural to you.
And let's see if we can, instead of dragging the right foot, see if you can silently lift the right foot. It meets the left at a plank. Again, make some circles over your wrist. Engage your core. Lift the backs of your legs up. Strong through your core and long. Imagine your toes are reaching for you, the heels of your hands and plank. The heels are reaching for the toes and plank. And back into downward facing dog. Step the left leg through. Actually, we have let's take this first into a side to side, kind of rock it out a little bit. Okay, do it on your hands or your forearms. Just moving your hips side to side, shoulders, wrists. Let's move it side to side. Fold over the leg. Let's do 4 or 5 of these. Inhale, chin up, look up, hip, leg bends. And exhale, straighten the leg forward. And look up. And fold over. And look up. And fold over. And look up. And fold over. Before we do some back bends on this side, let's reach back the leg, straight back, and reach right arm straight up, because we almost forgot this side. Breathe, lengthen. Belly and core engaged, strong through the core. And then knee and head touch, and reach back. 5, 3, 4, 1. Straight back. And step again between your hands. Lunge. You can come down to your elbow if you like. Bend the right knee. Sorry, left knee. Left, you're holding on to the left foot. So your right foot with your left hand. Right foot, left hand. Left foot, right hand. Lots of lefts and rights. Breathe. Let's come back to me. Reach it up and take the dancing reverse warrior path. And switch arms, take a deep back inhale. And fold over the left leg.
Release your neck. Foot comes high.
Do a little balance here, a little balance practice before we get into our long flow. So lift the left leg up and down, come forward. That's tricky. We're going to place the left knee. First we're going to bring it up, knee up, and then place the left knee next to the right. Okay. Right knee into your chest. Right knee reaches forward. Take the lunge. Little balance. Lift the right knee up. Left knee down. Excellent. Now we're going just a couple more here. For the balance, left knee reaches up. Lunge forward. And back. Left knee reaches up and then you place it down next to your right. It's good if it's wildly. It's good to challenge yourself in all different planes. Knee bends, back, table. Let's flip the table. Let's rock, about count of 10. Core's engaged. And let's take a downward facing dog. The first one, you're gonna peel it out. Let's take the knees to the left.
Let's take a twist. Our hips all the way down. Let's twist over the right shoulder. Let's reach around. Do the same thing. And into the knees. Take it nice and slow all the way till your hips reach the floor. Take a twist away from the legs. Hips up to the ceiling. Right leg sweeps the sky. This is the beginning of our flow. Right leg steps through, left knee comes down.
Interlace the hands. Let go. Crescent pose, right leg. Let's reach your hands around, clasp them. Fold over the right leg with clasped hands.
You're still using the core for balance. And bend the right leg. Let's come up into a humble crescent pose. Low crescent. Let's reach the throat forward, gaze forward. Come into a bound warrior three. And step through. Excellent. Left knee comes up. You can hold on to the knee. Hold onto the foot and take dancing Shiva pose. Knee back, release into a twisted half moon pose. Breathe. Take the left knee down, right, left foot to the floor. You keep the right leg where it is. This is a side plank modified. You can keep the right foot on the floor to keep a plank modified. Or you can take the right foot in for a tree, whatever you want to do. Next step is wild thing. Step the right foot behind. Open the heart for wild thing. From wild thing, we're going to reach the knee to the chest and send it to the right, all the way out. A few breaths here for the right hip. And fallen pigeon. Let's take the right knee in. Left knee comes on for sway side to side. In your Gomukhasana. Right hand comes down, lift your hips up for a easy twist. Take a horizon pose. Easy twist. Frame the left foot. Step into a warrior three. Bring the right knee into the chest. Take a figure four. Hands on your hip, take your right foot straight in front of you. Lift it, reach around to the side. Take a tree pose. Back into warrior three. Hands frame the right, the foot. Take it to the floor. Take your pyramid pose.
over the leg for horizon pose. Reach up for high horizon pose. Low horizon pose. Inside of the foot. Can keep your right knee up or down. Lizard lunge. You keep your right knee down. See if you can bend the right foot. If you'd like, see if you can clasp the right foot behind you. Reach the foot away. Release the heel toe, the left foot across the mat, and take the left side. Fallen pigeon. Breathe. If you want to take this low, kick your knee into your chest, set it back to the ceiling. So left foot comes through. Cartwheel your arms to warrior two. Left knee is bent and forward. Reverse your warrior, peaceful warrior, breathe. Hand to knee, side angle pose. If you want your hands on the floor, breathe. We're going to reach forward with the right hand and come into a sugar cane pose. Twisted again. This side. I'm going to try to remember all this. And that's open up into a half moon. Normal half moon. Breathe. Take your right knee right behind the left knee and come down for a twist. Go to the left shoulder. You can take your right ear to your right shoulder, releasing your neck. Look over to the ceiling. Take your left ear to your left shoulder. Look over your left shoulder. Take your left knee over your right. This time we'll fold forward. The right hand right in line with the right left foot for the twist, easy twist. We come up and take a standing twist, arms in prayer, take a twist pose. You put the right knee on the ground, take the right foot towards your hip if you can. Release the right foot down. If you want to keep it down or not, release the using your core for the supporting twist here. Let's take this into Skandasana. Left side is bent. Let's stay low for Skandasana, right side. Skandasana, left side. Back to the twist. We're going to step into a plank pose. Let's hold it for 10. Core's engaged. And hips are forward, shoulders back, heart lifts. Let's tense your hand, foot, come down.
to an oscillating cobra. Press your fingertips in. Lift your heart, squeeze your butt. Press your toes down, lift. Take your right shoulder down. And then come up. Left shoulder down. Look over your right shoulder. We can rest your chin. Inhale, look up. Roll down. Spread the right leg right on behind you. Shoulder opening pose. And just can either keep your right hand in front of you, behind you. Bend the left leg. And breathe into the shoulder opening for the right side. Lovely. We'll have to get make sure we get that on the other side. Roll over. Inhale, look up. Back into cobra. From cobra, we are going to go back to a child's pose for a brief second. From child's pose, we're going to take puppy pose. We are going to take it with blocks to really open our armpits and back and chest. So if you don't have blocks, you can just tense your fingertips out. If you have blocks, keep your hands on blocks, knees under your hips, and just shift your forehead towards the ground. If you can get your chest to the ground, wherever you can be, breathe. Forehead. Walk your hands to your shoulders. Roll back to your seat. Tuck your chin. You're on all of your toes, stretching out all of your toes. Clasp your hands behind your back, open your heart. Breathe. You get to do the other side now. So you can stay clasped here. Take your left leg forward. Let's reach forward for a straighten the right knee up, humble crescent pose. Use the core for balance. Come to the right foot for bound warrior three, reach the gaze, reach the heel, find the core. And then come back there, right knee to your chest. You can hold the knee, hold the knee. If you want to hold the foot for Shiva, dancing pose, looking over the right shoulder, breathe. Figure four. Find your balance. Take a squat. We're going to open up into a twisted half moon pose. Release the right foot back for a pyramid pose. We're going to twist on the feet as we come into a side angle, side plank. So you could stay here in a modified side plank, or you can come to a tree plank, or you can grab piece fingers around your foot for a side angle B, side plank B. Come back. Easy twist. Let's scoot the right knee under. Oscillating. All right. Cow face pose. Let's take the twist again. Let's come up into a reverse twist. Open up into a warrior two. Reverse the warrior. Take a sugar cane, Ardha Chandrasana. I'm going to come back, knee through, again, the center. We're going to take the right hands around the right foot, stretch the right foot out. And bring the right foot out to the right. Let's reach around for the, keep the right foot up as you reach it back. Back to a lunge. Let's turn this around. All the way through Skandasana. Through Skandasana again. Skandasana. Let's come to a pyramid pose. Let's kick switch the feet so we get to do the other side. The right leg needs to be on top. So, and the right left leg, switch. Okay, now here we go, right up. Come into a dancing Shiva. Come into a figure four squat pose. I'm going to blossom into a half moon pose. Fold over the right leg. Fold like if we're standing split. Just drop the right leg behind. Let's walk our feet, hands stretch in mechanic pose. Hands under your face, left arm sweeps the sky. Look at the left hand. Try to get this stretched through the middle of your back so the hips are even here. And to the other side, hips are even. Look at the fingers. Now lift the hip, right hip up, and give a slight inner thigh stretch. And hip. Lift the left hip up and get a right inner thigh stretch. And come back down to Skandasana, left side. Take this into a twist. Left hand reaches up. Easy twist. Let's take a twist. You can drop the right knee to the floor. Take the right foot to your hips. Release the foot. Come up and release the hands. Let's go to Skandasana on the left side. And across Skandasana, right side. Across Skandasana, left side to Horizon Pose. Look over the hands. And then lift your hips for High Horizon Pose. And lower for Low Horizon Pose. And around,
twist to the right, left, right hand raises up, left hand plants, arms straight. Let's come into a twist this way, rotate the arms for a warrior two. Reverse warrior. Side angle. Plant. Hand framing the right foot. Swinging the right foot to the sky. Slower down, nice and slow return. Let's take the oscillating cobra. Lift the heart, squeeze your shoulders back and down, and then roll to the center. A little wider, maybe apart. Lift your chin up, tuck your tailbone, squeeze your butt. Squeeze your finger with your toenails. Right elbow, right hand to the ground. Inhale, come up. And switch over left arm. Looking over to the right. And then come on up. Let's come to a high cobra. Squeeze your butt. And press into your knees for a poem. Puppy pose. Roll through each vertebra for a Sphinx pose and stay here. If this is comfortable or you feel it's enough for you today, if you want a little extra, come onto a block under your elbows, shoulders back down, breathe, lift through your heart. And press your elbows as you reach your hips up. I'm gonna take the elbows down into another puppy pose. Elbows are in the block. Maybe forehead comes to the ground. Press into your elbows again and walk your knees. And let's end right where we started in child's pose. Feel the difference in your body and your energy. Let's clasp our hands behind our back. Let's roll to the back of our head. Bring your wrists in front of you. Big stretch for the shoulders and rabbit pose. And back onto all of your toes. Let's just take your hands to your knees. Chin to your chest. Let's clasp and hug both your shoulders. Give yourself a nice big hug. Chin, chin tucks.
And then open your arms wide. Heart lifts, shoulders reach down and make an offering of your heart. Hands behind you, just go back. Take a seat, getting ready for Shavasana. Let's take one twist before we Shavasana. Knees into your heart. Squeeze everything in. If you want to take a back bend here, if that will make you practice feel complete, you'll have plenty of time to take a few nice long back bends if you like, or if you want to wind it down with me here. Just gonna squeeze your arms into your chest. Let's put the feet towards the edges of the mat for constructive rest. Bring your knees together. Let's shift our knees over to the right. Hips over to the right, knees to the left. Look over the right shoulder. You know what, I think I forgot the shoulder stretch for the left side. So I think it'll be a fun transition to just roll right on, hands over your head, take your knees over your stomach, roll over, give forehead. We're going to, we stretched out the right arm, right? So this time, we will stretch out the left arm. So roll onto this side, hands is up, get your right hand behind you. Roll over your legs again. You know, this is a wonderful place actually to take hands above, reach above your head, and you can take prostration pose as final corpse pose, or if you prefer to roll on your back, you can do that too. Wherever you are, just think about surrendering into the universe. Let go. You're on your stomach, you want to roll over, just thread the needle under your arm and then roll over into your back. Take up space, all the space you need. Try not to rush this. This is the time of your healing. This is the time of your integrating and creating muscle memory. Incorporating everything you've opened and surrendering to the spirit. This is the most important pose in a self-care series. Treat yourself. Enjoy it. Reach our hands over our head. Reach and stretch. Stretch your heels. Reach, 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 reach your fingertips. Reach everything, reach everything. And let's relax. Let it go. Again, the hands are over your head. You just roll over, make a pillow with your fists, or stay in Shavasana as long as you want. I don't want to be the one to rush you out. And I'm going to get ready to close this. So I'm going to come to a seated position. And bring your hands to your heart. Let's seal this with an om, the sound of all prayers. Thoughts, words, and actions be loving and kind. May we see the divine light in all beings. May be happy. May be radiant and joyful and blissful. And filled with love. That's what you're meant to be. Blessings on blessings. Keep coming back. Share and subscribe. Let me know how you did. Let me know where you're from. I put that in the comment. I'd like to know. That's big curiosity. Thank you.